I don't understand how people who work with MIP in Revit don't use these sort of scripts daily. Revit doesn't give you the total length of its systems by default, and this may cause you problems both for quantity surveillance and for calculus. Today, I'm going to write one script to solve this issue. So, let's see exactly what we have to do. So first of all, here we have our 3D model, and inside our 3D model, we have our different systems, and what we want is the total length per system. Why? Because it's just disappointing that when you go and check for a duct, for instance, here you do have the length. Here you can see 6 feet, 10 inches, something like that. But when you go for the complete system, when you try to select the complete system, you don't have the total system length, and that will cause trouble for calculating and for quantity surveillance. So we don't know the length of this whole system. What's the matter? Well, in this system, we have elements such as this one, which is a duct, in which we do have the length. However, we have other elements such as this one, which is a duct fitting, and here we don't have the length directly. So different kinds of elements do have different kinds of length, and we have to take all that into account when considering the total system length. We are going to calculate the total system length of one system. I'm going to start just with one. If you don't know how to do one, how are you expecting to do them all? So when we go, for instance, for a piece such as this one, this duct fitting, we may have to guess the length, taking into account it may be the length 1, or perhaps it's the center radius, or perhaps we will have to consider the angle. We don't know, we will have to check it out as we go. So let's start just with one system. I'm going to try to transmit to a parameter called total system length the whole length of this full system that I'm selecting right now. So what am I going to do? First, open Dynamo, of course. So opening a new Dynamo, and then the first thing that you may consider is, all right, so let's isolate these elements, let's isolate this whole system. So I click the whole system, and then right here I'm going to select isolate element. So there I have only the elements I'm currently interested in. After that, I'm going to select these elements with select model elements, and I click select, and I select all of them. So this way, if I click run, I already know that I have all the elements in the system, and only those. Then I'm going to separate the elements by category. So I'm going to get the category of these elements with element get category. Why do I need this? Well, because as I told you before, there are different ways of getting the length. The ducts do have the length directly, but the other pieces may not be so direct. So now let's group the different elements by their category with a group by key node. Which elements have to be grouped? The ones on the system. What is the key to grouping them? Their category. So there you go. This way we have the ducts in one list and the duct fittings in a second list. And we have the air terminals also on a third list. So first thing we have here is the element selection. And secondly, we have grouped here the elements by their category. So now I'm going to split up the groups, and I'm going to leave the ducts in one place, the duct fittings in another, and the air terminal in a third group. How do we do that? Well, we may do this like this, by using code block. Where ducts were concerned, we already have the parameter at the length parameter. So let's get it. With get parameter value by name, we select the ducts as elements and the parameter name, which is length. And if we run this, we already have here the length. Of course, in this point of the video, you may be wondering, yes, Luis, very nice, the get parameter value by name. I'm sure this is a great node, but how am I supposed to know that I need to use this node and not any of the other nodes that I can find in the search bar in Dynamo? How do I know I need to use this exact node? Well, in the beginning you can know it, because practice makes the master. And this is a situation that I call the sea of nodes. When you're getting completely lost, by all the information that is currently on the internet. Thousands and thousands of notes, and you don't even know how to get one. So this is why in the Dynamo Python Mastery of BoldBrain, we use something that we have called the 2080. You may be wondering, what the hell is that? That is simply teaching you the 20% of notes that you will be needing to use in 80% of your script. This is something like trying to learn English by learning the most useful phrases, something like that, because programming is a language and you aren't going to learn a language by looking or reading at a dictionary. That's highly inefficient. So this is why we use the 2080. So we may not know it until someone who does have the practice tells us. But what we do know is that right now we have here the length of the ducts, and here we have the different elements separated by their category. So if I copy this, and if instead of ducts I select the duct fittings and I run this, as you can see, everything is blank. Why is that? Well, because the duct fittings do not have the length in the length parameter. So what do we need to do? So we head to Revit and check the different parameters of these duct fittings. In this case, we have the round elbow, and we have the angle, the center radius, size. So let's look at the family. And here I can see that I do have the center radius. The length one is something completely different to what I want, because what I want is this part, and the length one is that part. So I will need to calculate the length. How can I do that? Well, I do have the length radius and I also have the angle. So let's use both of those. Perhaps it's here somewhere in the parameters of the family. Doesn't seem like this. Why do I know this? Well, because in order to get the length of the arc of a circle, I need the radius of the circle and also the angle that it covers in radians. And I don't have anything like that here. So let's calculate that in Dynamo. So the length of this will be the radius per the angle in radians. So let's write that down. And the angle in radians is the angle in degrees per P and between 180. There I have it written down. And let's connect this with this one, angle in radians with that one. And of course, I do have the P variable here, which I need to include here. So what am I missing? The radius and the degree in angles. And where is that? In my duct fittings, I have the radius as center radius. So let's see where we do have the center radius. It seems that we are lucky indeed. And we also need the angle. So let's copy that. This is the center radius. And we also need the angle. And we already have that there. So now all that is missing is connecting the center radius with the radius and the angle in degrees with that one. And if I click run, I already have here the length of all the duct fittings. But which units are we using here? Because as you can see here in the ducts, we have 3.83, 1.98, and however, in the duct fittings, we have 9.42, which is bigger, but it doesn't make sense because normally the duct fittings are smaller than the ducts. So perhaps the problem is in the units. Let's check it up. So here, if I go to a duct fitting, I can see this is measured in inches, the size, and the radius is in inches. However, I have the length of the ducts in feet. So we have two different units that we have to consider when working with Dynamo. We have to either convert the inches to feet or the feet to inches. But let's be realistic with the measurements. So I'm going to be converting the inches to feet. So an inch is 0.0833333 feet. So inches to feet equals inch per this. And that does look way better when considering the units. So conversion. And now once I have everything in the same unit, I can sum it up. So first let's join these two lists. First one and second one. And here I have all the measures together. Wait a minute, if you have arrived to this point in the video and you are going to be using this knowledge that LadyBeam is giving to you, please leave a comment, leave an emoji down below on the video. This helps me both know that you have reached this part of the video and that you want me to keep doing videos just like this one. And what else is missing? Yes, summing up all the values. Let's go. So we have already joined all the different measurements and we just have to sum it up. The total length of all our system is 33.84 feet. So last step is to put that information inside our total system length parameter. Let's do that. Set parameter by name, and we have here the value. The parameter name is total system length, and our elements were right at the beginning all together. So last step, storing the information inside the elements. We have it right here. Let's run this. Oh, we do have a null element, number 9, which is our air terminal because I didn't introduce the total system length parameter in this air terminal. So that is completely normal. Let's check this up. And here it is. The total system length, 33 feet and 10 inches, something like that. So here I have this information in each and every element of the system. Cool, right? So if you have found this video useful, please don't forget to check our Dynamo Python Mastery right here. And of course, you can subscribe to the channel. See you on the next one. Bye-bye.